You're listening to the audio production of the Read and Share Bible by Gwen Ellis, published by Tommy Nelson and read by Douglas Fiacre.
The First Day, Genesis chapter 1, verses 1 through 5. In the beginning, God made heaven and earth. At first, it was empty and dark. But God gathered up the light and called it day. Then he gathered up the darkness and called it night. God was watching over everything. What do you think God did next? The second day, Genesis chapter 1, verses 6 through 8. On day 2, God divided the air from the water. He put some water above the air and some below it. He named the air sky. The next day, God made something many children like, especially in the summer. Can you guess what it is? The third day, Genesis chapter 1, verses 9 through 13. On day 3, God was busy. He made puddles and oceans and lakes and waterfalls and rivers. He made the dry ground too. Next, he made plants. He made so many different kinds of trees, flowers, and bushes that no one could count them all. God said his work was good. Wow! God made so much on that day. But can you guess what was missing? The fourth day. Genesis, chapter 1, verses 14 through 19. On day 4, God put the sun in the sky to warm the earth. He saw that the night was very dark. So God put the moon and the stars in the sky. Then God made spring, summer, fall, and winter. All that he made was good. Next, God made flippy, flappy, fun things. Let's see what they were. The fifth day, Genesis chapter 1, verses 20 through 23. On day 5, God made starfishes, octopuses, whales, and turtles. He made fast little fish for rivers and slippery big fish for the ocean. He made big birds like eagles to soar in the sky, and zippy little birds like hummingbirds. He made birds in all shapes, sizes, and colors. Which bird do you think is the prettiest? Which is the strongest? The sixth day, Genesis chapter 1, verses 24 through 31. On day 6, God made the animals, puppies, cows, horses, kitties, bears, lizards, mice, worms, and lots more. Everything was good. But something was still missing. There were no people, so God made some, and when he made them like himself. He made them so they could be friends with him. Where do you think the first people lived? Adam and Eve. Genesis, chapter 2, verses 1 through 5 and 15 through 22, and chapter 3, verse 20. God named the first man Adam. God put Adam in a beautiful garden. He gave him all the animals. He gave him all the fish and the birds, too. Then God gave Adam one more thing. God made a woman to be Adam's wife. Adam named his wife Eve. On day 7, God rested from all his work. Uh-oh! Something bad was about to happen on the earth. The sneaky snake. Genesis chapter 2, verses 16 through 17, and chapter 3, verses 1 through 6. God gave Adam and Eve one rule. Eat anything you like, except the fruit from the tree in the middle of the garden. A sneaky old snake came to Eve. Eat it. Then you'll know everything, just like God. So Eve ate the fruit and gave some to Adam, and he ate it too. When we disobey God, it's called sin. There are always consequences when we disobey. Out of the garden. Genesis chapter 3, verses 8 through 24. One evening, God came to visit Adam and Eve. But they were hiding. When God found them, he asked, "What have you done?" Adam told God everything. God was sad. Because they had disobeyed God, Adam and Eve had to leave the beautiful garden. When they were outside of the garden, Adam and Eve had to work very hard to grow food. It makes God very sad when we disobey. It makes our parents sad, too. Noah, Genesis, chapter 6. Many years later, there were lots of people on the earth, but most of them were bad. One man, Noah, was good. He obeyed God. "I want you to build a boat," God told Noah. Noah started right away. People laughed at Noah because they lived in a desert and there was no water for his boat. Noah just went on building the boat. Do you think it's easy to obey when everyone is laughing at you? The big boat. Genesis chapter 7, verses 1 through 15. When the boat was finished, God told Noah and his family to go into the boat. In went his sons, Shem, Ham, and Japheth. In went their wives and Mrs. Noah. "Now bring two of every animal," God told Noah. Noah did exactly what God told him to do, and God watched over him. Something very wet was about to happen outside, inside the boat. Genesis, chapter 7, verses 16 through 24. When the last animal climbed into the boat, God shut the door. Plip, plop. Plip. It began to rain. It rained so much, the water was over the meadows. It rained so much, it covered the towns. It rained so much, it even covered the mountains. But inside the boat, everyone was safe. How many days do you think it rained? The dove. Genesis chapter 7, verse 12, and chapter 8, verses 1 through 19. After 40 days and 40 nights, the rain stopped. But it still wasn't time to get off the boat. Water was everywhere. One day, Noah let a little dove fly out to see what was happening on the earth. It brought a green leaf back. Hooray! The plants were growing again. It was almost time to come out. What do you think everyone did when Noah opened the door of the boat? The rainbow. Genesis, chapter 8, verses 18 through 22, and chapter 9, verses 1 through 17. When everyone was out of the boat, Noah built an altar. He thanked God for keeping them safe. Then, something wonderful happened. God put a beautiful rainbow in the sky and made Noah a promise. It will never flood over the whole earth like that again, God said. When God makes a promise, he keeps it. All God's promises are in the Bible. Isn't it wonderful to think of all he has promised us? Babel. Genesis, chapter 11, verses 1 through 9. Many years later, there were lots of people on the earth. They all spoke the same language. Some people who lived in the city of Babel became too proud. Let's build a tower that reaches to the sky. We'll be famous. God caused them to speak different languages, so they couldn't talk to one another. Because they couldn't understand one another, they stopped building the tower. Do you have any friends who speak a foreign language? Are you patient with them? Abram. Genesis, chapter 12, verses 1 through 3. Chapter 15, verse 5. And chapter 22, verse 17. God picked Abram to be the father of a very important family. One day in the future, Jesus would come from this family. God told Abram, I will make you famous. Your children and grandchildren will be as many as the stars. They will be as many as the grains of sand on the beach. You won't be able to count them. Wow, that's a wonderful promise. How do you think Abram felt? Promised Land. Genesis, chapter 12, verses 1 through 9. God told Abram to move to a new place. Abram had no map. God said, I will show you where to go. Abram started out walking. He took his wife, nephew, and servants with him. When Abram and his family got to a land called Canaan, God said, This is your new home. I am giving it to you and to everyone who will ever be in your family. If your parents said, We're going on a trip, but we can't tell you where, would you trust them to take you to a good place? Abraham's visitors. Genesis, chapter 17, verses 1 through 8, and chapter 18, verses 1 through 8. When Abraham was 99 years old, God changed his name to Abraham. His new name showed that he belonged to God. Not long after that, three men came by Abraham's tent, and he invited them to lunch.
Quick, bake some bread,
Abraham told his wife. Then Abraham hurried to get some meat cooked. When the food was ready, Abraham brought it.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.